Hi guys, welcome to a TrainSim TV video for Train Simulator 2018. Today I'm going to be showing you something new for the West Coast Main Line South V5. This route is available from UKTrainSim and has been for about a week almost now. As there was no scenarios for the route apart from quick drives, I took it upon myself to attempt making quite a complex scenario for the Bakerloo Line. So far, probably the most amount of enjoyment I've had out of route for a while. So it's taken me about 6 hours to create. So it's in the planning, it's in the testing stages, which I think now it's about ready to get released. So sit back, guys, enjoy, and I hope you enjoy it. So hello and good morning, driver. Today you're in charge of 203D Harrow and Wealdstone to Elephant Castle along the Bakerloo Line. You're clear to head into the station once the Class 370 London Overground service has cleared the signal at the end of Harrow and Wealdstone. Your departure time is at 7:52. So let's get ourselves set up. So it's CTRL, Shift and S to set this unit up. That pulls us into forward. It's pretty much standard, really. It's quite easy to set up. And already you can see there's quite a lot going on. This route was created by originally Photon 66, I think his username is, off UKTrainSim. The route has been taken over by Alex 55, also from UKTrainSim, and has, from what I believe, has given a lot of track rebuilding, resignaling, overhead wiring, and all that lot. Added the Bakerloo line to its entirety up to Elephant Castle. So we're heading down here today. And we are starting up here. It's about a 52 minute journey. As you can see, the route's huge. It runs from Euston all the way to Birmingham New Street. So we can head into the station now. Those of you that come into my stream, you will have seen the scenario, but it didn't go to plan. There was a few AI collisions, so I decided to not keep showing it off until I'd sort the problem. I think I've got it now, so fingers crossed this run goes smoothly. So as we have said, our departure time, I think, is 07:42, 50 seconds or so, by the time the doors do shut. We are calling all stops en route, so we've got Harrow and Wealdstone, Kenton, South Kenton, North Wembley, Wembley Central, Stonebridge Park, Halston, Wealdstone Junction, Kensal Green, Queen's Park, Kilburn Park, Maida Vale, Warwick Avenue, Paddington, Edgware Road, Marylebone, Baker Street, Regent's Park, Oxford Circus, Piccadilly Circus, Charing Cross, Embankment, Waterloo, Lambeth North, and finally Elephant and Castle, giving us 25 stops in a 14.20 mile distance of travelling. So there's plenty to do, plenty to see, should be good. All trains are coming to this little shunt neck here, then they'll turn around and then go back and do the trip once more. This section's also shared with London Overground services. As you can see, there is one on its way down. These run from Euston to Watford. Watford Junction, I think it is, if I'm right correctly. Links will be posted below the video to grab this route. Once approved, the route, the scenario for this route will be released via UKTrainSim. Possibly UKTrainSim. Sorry, Vulcan Production definitely may find its way onto UKTrainSim also. The links will get shared around everywhere anyway. Once it has been released. Certainly getting better at the stopping this unit. First I was overshooting platforms, trying to get used to the brakes. Couple of gripes with the route. Now it's fantastic, I like the route. For me, now I have notified the route author for the terrain textures that don't match up with the AP track. I understand they do match more with the default track, but if you have this AP patch, then they don't look right. From what I'm aware, he's looking into a possibility of maybe doing something for it. Not certain, maybe. Overhead wiring's absolutely fantastic though, as you can see. Plenty of detail going on. Fantastic signalling also, especially for Birmingham. Plenty of realistic types being used, like sideways signals and that. If you don't see it, I know they're not custom signals, I think they've just been flicking to the side, but it shows them the detail that they've put there before. Just give that a bit more realism. So the frames per second on this route are very good, despite the length of the route. It runs really well. Plenty of atmosphere going on, plenty of detail. hardest part for this scenario was trying to contend with the amount of lines we've got running here. So we've got four main lines, and we've got the overground and underground route. Just trying to fill everything up and get it working was a bit of a task, hence why it took about 6 or 7 hours to create this one. I think it's the most in-depth scenario I've created in the whole about 10 years that I've been playing Train Simulator. So I'm quite impressed that it's working so far. Next stop is North Wembley. Also, the way the route's been built, as you can see, not loads of detail, but the way it's been built is you're in the cab, you shouldn't need to be going all the way down here to look at a side street. It's all been built with the cab view, so when you're sitting there it looks full. There's plenty to see. Hence also why it gives you good FPS. It's not having to load as much in per tile, meaning you should also be able to get away with adding more AI really. Also, 164-bit does come along, which has been announced. That'll help out even more. But this has got about 50 AI. All sorts of little signs that have been made for this, so we're going with that one, obviously a bit too far in the wall. All the station signs have been made, and northbound, southbound sides, and I think some of the benches have been reskinned as well at certain platforms. They're not custom stations either, I think they just use what they've got and made them to look as close and represent what they need to in done a good job from what I can see. Also, look, nice little bit of detail there with wiring. Section gap signs. We are driving the 73 stock as well. These come with the virtual district underground route, which is the district line. I will cover that route at some stage on my videos, so keep posting, keep your eyes out. thing I like with this route is the fact there's two, there's the slow lines and the fast lines, so you've got different speed units chasing each other along to London. Stops Wilson Junction. Stop will be Kensal Green. Don't mind me while I'm flying around, just trying to get a decent screen grab for the thumbnail for the video. Thank you. stop is Queen's Park before we drop underground for the remainder of the journey. This is the next little section which I like. Going through the actual depot, you actually take your service through the depot, which is quite interesting. You don't get many places where you do that. It amazed me this when I came through here in real life a couple of years ago. When I was doing a couple of adventures around in London. I actually changed over from the Bakerloo Line to the Overground here to continue to Wealdstone. Then we took the North London Line down to Richmond. So some services do terminate here, so they do use this depot to do the shunt back into the platform to continue back to Elephant Castle, which this unit I think is doing now. Get like two services that terminate here and then another one goes through, I think, something like that. I'm not sure if it changes throughout the day, but from what I looked on the timetables, it looked like that. The timetables were quite fun to look at, trying to work out what was what. So you've got four platforms in the Queen's Park. You've got the two middle ones for the underground, and then the two outer platforms for the overground. Another little shed area down there. As you can see, we've got overground here, and that surface is just going into the depot area for its turnaround procedure. Once again, it's not custom; it's just been built with what they've got available, and it's a very, very close representation, to be quite honest. That. I remember it quite well. It just shows how close they run up here because one's gone out and one's come in. Start of the cool tunnels, which I was on about before. Once again, you see all the detail it brings. The tunnel wall. Even down the track bed section, you can see all the detail. So Gilbert Park is the next stop. These stations are quite special, also. See already. I believe the way it's been done, I think, is lofts, and then just the actual details have been added in by the looks of it along the way. if I've done this right. Yeah, that's just about right. I believe you have to stop just after the cab door with this little post sign. Cool signalling going on here. Yep, lovely detail. I think I might have fixed an issue. I had milk bottles hanging down where these lights are. Now I think I might have fixed that by actually doing my tutorial video before. And don't forget the East Coast Main Line, Moorgate, which I did on my tutorial before this, so I think I fixed another problem. It was a good job I did that. Getting a steady 45 FPS in this section of the route now. Next stop's Maida Vale. Just gotta be careful of the speed on this, obviously up and down all the time. It's quite a test. Not done that though, have I? A little bit too far. Oops. Like I say, I'm still getting to the grips of stopping this thing at the right place, so there will be mistakes. Try and get a screenshot here. Get into position. Give it a go. Obviously, doesn't help. Am I in the cab? Selling it, am I? Driving this stock. Mistakes will be made, and if you watch my streams, then obviously you'll know mistakes get made quite a lot. Links will be provided anyway for the stream in the briefing underneath, or the description of the video. I stream most nights of the week. Tend to do one-off, providing work. I'm not doing like a late shift or not. Yeah, tend to do one-on, one-off, or you might get an extra bonus stream in the week, providing if I'm on early. I've got nothing on. Usually do different variety of routes, different locos, steam, diesel, European. Thank you. also every so often to vary it up and try and help people out as best I can. Edgware Road's next. So we're 15 stations in out of our 25, so we've got Marylebone next, and then Baker Street, Regent's Park, Oxford Circus, Piccadilly Circus, Charing Cross, Embankment, Waterloo, Lambeth North and Elephant and Castle. We're due into Elephant Castle about 8:30 in the game time. Something I'd like to see maybe down the line is the use of the Just Train signalling assets. Can't really tell it here, but they are I think UK Pro signals at the minute. It'd be nice if we can get the Aylesbury Met Line signalling installed onto it. Other than that, the stations are absolutely spot on. Plenty on them, loads of adverts. perfect at the last. It's only taken me how many stops. I like this as well, these little steps. Nice little details like that. Obviously each tube station has its own pattern, doesn't it? I'd like to have a little explore, see what's what. I do give this, I give it strong marks out of 10, probably about 9. Only thing for me is if you can get the just train signalling, it'd probably a 10. This is the most fun on a route I've had for a while. This nature, obviously. Don't urge you going outside of the view. Of the way it's been built to make it look like this is the underground. But yeah, the detail and everything, I give it a good strong 9 out of 10. So them signals that'll do me. I've yet to do a proper scenario for the mainline section. I've done a quick drive, but I need to do it with stock. To get the full marks for me, it needs to be signalled correctly and run correctly and be easy to work with to make stuff. But we shall have a go at that at some point. Hopefully you'll hear from me on that also. But this works well, it's signalled well on this line. It's easy to work with. It works straight out of the box. Driving more sloppy again now. Very sloppy. One thing I do recommend is if you do come to download the route and come to use the stock in your own scenarios, if you ever use the pre-made contest for the stock, please note that it's only got 6 cars and there should be 7, so you'll have to add in a car manually, which I had to do. Not sure if that was an accidental error, it could be, maybe it might get amended, I'm not sure. not sure if that's down to the consist that the stock author rather than the route author. Just make note on it if you want to make correct authentic scenarios. Next up's Charing Cross. That's cool. It's clever how it's been done with lofts, but there's also assets in there that make it work. Fair enough, it obviously goes to middle lower. Got a bit of a drop down into embankment. Coming up in a second. It was 25 mile an hour down to embankment. So we've got Waterloo, Lambeth North and Elephant Castle left to serve on this run. A journey shouldn't take any more than an hour in each direction. That's depending if you do the full run and not a short run. Next up is Waterloo. Does it? Every time I do it, I always seem to stop this about a distance. Good job, the brakes are quite decent on it. One thing I do like with this unit. A little passenger view also. Not the best, but it works. It might be a little bit low quality down to my graphical settings at the minute. On my stream settings, so they're knocked down a bit, so they might be a little more better if I upped them a bit less blurry. Cab's basic. sign of bedtime is what it is. Which is where we'll be going after we finish this. Better driving, hopefully, next time. We've only got one stop to do now, Elephant Castle. Perfect stop for the last one at least. I do hope you've enjoyed this video anyway, and I hope it does urge you to download it, as I do recommend it fully. The link will be below the video. Please hit the subscribe button below. Also, if you can tip the little bell, you'll get notification whenever I put a new video up. Also, I will put the information for the streams in the description. Nice to see you on there if you ever have a moment to come and say hello. There's a good bunch of guys on there, we have a good laugh when we do it. Always open to suggestions also. Any feedback, please put it in the comments below and I will get back to you and hopefully improve, especially with driving, in future videos. So thank you very much guys, and take care and see you on the next one.